Hey, this is Kirk from the DynamoDB team, and today we are talking about global tables. So let's get going.
Global tables for Amazon DynamoDB provides your application with multi-region tables that are replicated to and active in all regions you select. It is fully managed, and once enabled, there is really not much for you to do on an ongoing basis. Every region's replica is active as there are no read replicas in global tables. You'll see this called multi-region, multi-active. This means your app communicates with the local replica, but your data is replicated by DynamoDB to all of the AWS regions that you have selected for that global table. If you have an existing single region table, it can easily be converted to a global table with no downtime. In addition, it is just as easy to add and remove regions to existing global tables. Your data is secure as all of your data is encrypted in transit and at rest. One thing to note is your table must be configured to use either on-demand capacity mode, or if you are using provision capacity mode, auto-scaling must be enabled. Now that you know the basics of global tables in DynamoDB, let's dive that next level deeper into how things operate and what you need to know to be successful with it. DynamoDB global table replicas are interconnected, but they are not interdependent. This means table replicas are connected and do exchange data, but their functioning and maintenance are not dependent upon each other. If something happens in AWS region A, it does not affect other global table replicas in other regions. Your app should be writing to the replica in the same region as the app for the lowest latency and overall performance. With that, your data will usually propagate to other replicas within 1 second. Keep in mind, these writes are eventually consistent across global table replicas. As you might imagine, this means you could have conflicts if you are updating the same item in one or more regions. In this case, global tables will use what's called last writer wins algorithm to reconcile the conflicts. Last writer wins means that whichever replica writes the latest version of the item, that is the one that wins and will be written to all other replicas. Along with this, operations such as conditional expressions, atomic updates, and transactions are on a regional basis. Therefore, think of it like this. Data modifications for those local operations will replicate across the global table, but not the operations themselves. For example, if you perform a transact write operation in region A, those writes will be committed locally as part of that transaction. The data changed by those operations will be replicated to regions B and C, but not written as a transactional operation in those other regions. One thing to note is that with global tables, writes to your table are priced differently as they will be replicated to other replicas in the global table. Instead of a write capacity unit or write request unit, it is a replicated write capacity unit or a replicated write request unit. Whether it is a capacity unit or a request unit is determined by the capacity mode the global table is in. So why does any of this matter? When you use global tables for DynamoDB, it gives your application higher availability, more durability, and better fault tolerance. In disaster recovery planning terms, your database would meet a recovery time objective of near zero and a recovery point objective of about 1 second. To strengthen that even more, using global tables means you get a database uptime service level agreement from AWS of 99.999%. There's one other use case for global tables that you should know about, and that's when migrating between regions. Let's say you are currently in region A and now want to move your entire infrastructure to region B. You enable global tables by adding a replica in region B. Once your data is fully replicated over and your application is moved over as well, you are now free to make final arrangements for that now legacy environment in region A. Now let's talk a little bit about setup and operation. You can use the AWS console, API, CLI, CloudFormation, or CDK to operate everything with global tables. All right, so now it is demo time. Right now I am on the global tables tab of my music table. I'm going to hit create replica because I want to create a new global table. I'm going to add this one to US West Oregon. One thing to note here is that because on this table I do not have DynamoDB streams enabled, this will enable it for me because it relies on DynamoDB streams. And now DynamoDB is in the background creating a replica in US West 2 and streaming any data that I have. There's no data in this table right now, but if there was, it would start streaming that. So we're going to explore tables. We're going to create a new item. Since the music table, we'll put in here Radiohead as the artist. And as the, for the sort key, we have the song title, Paranoid Android. All right. And hit create item. So now when we go over to US West 2, look in our tables, we see the music table. And we look under Explore Table Items, we see that there is Radiohead and Paranoid Android.
In summary, use DynamoDB Global Tables if you need better fault tolerance and durability of your data as part of your overall disaster recovery plan, for when you need to replicate data between AWS regions to get data closer to your customers, and when you need to migrate between AWS regions. Thanks, to be on the lookout for more Core Concept videos here and on our Twitter handle @DynamoDB.